Oh, you're working. Well, that won't be long, sweetheart. Did you speak with the lender? Not yet. Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Uh-huh. Well, as soon as you call the lender and get your pre-approval, we can start looking at property. And remember, our deadline is April, because we're trying to get you that first-time home buyer's $8,000 credit. If you can't physically call her, let Jose call her. And just get it started with your information. Yes. Or she can ask for the file from the other lender, but it's usually easier for her to just do a profile on you, and that's getting your information on the 1003. Okay? All right, so you... First of all, your name, address, social security number. Yeah, and then she's going to ask you... Right, pretty much. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right, right. Well, just introduce yourself to her, a quick phone call, and then that way she'll know to look out for your information if you need to send it via email or what have you. So she can just get the process started for you. Yeah, all right? And I'm sorry? Okay, sounds good. Okay. That sounds great. All right, thanks so much, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye. So that was a buyer who needs to get pre-qualified, and she's taking her time, and she's a first-time home buyer, and she's going to miss out on the April 30th new home buyer credit.
What's the April...
That's the cutoff time
for your first-time home buyer. Can we do that one more time? Can you, like, hang up and just be like, she's going to miss out on this, and then just explain, oh, do you not know what it's about? This is it. That's what it means.
Okay.
And just explain it. Okay.
Ready? So that was a buyer that I'm working with, and she's a first-time home buyer, and she's really anxious to get started. However, there's a cutoff time as a first-time home buyer for you to qualify for the credit, which is a credit from the federal government of $8,000, and that's a pretty good chunk of change. So I'm trying to get her motivated to get qualified with one of our great lenders in downtown so we can start looking at homes so she can purchase before April 30th and so she can qualify for the credit.
And what are the benefits of doing that?
Well, the benefit of the credit is getting $8,000 tax credit.
And is that for anybody, or?
That would be for a first-time home buyer only. So you have to buy now. And they extended it. It actually was the cutoff last year, November 30th, but the federal government did decide to extend it because it was such a great program, and it motivated people to purchase. So it gives you purchasing power, and it's good for you to have that write-off amount. And so hopefully she'll call the lender, and we can get started.
That was perfect. Nice. Thanks.